revered Swami Nikaleshwarananda ji Maharaj, Swami Shuddhidananda ji Maharaj, Swami Satyadevananda ji Maharaj, all the revered monks of Ramakrishna Mission sitting here, the invited guest, and my dear sisters and brothers, my namaskars to you all. Today, the topic that Swami Vivekananda's message to the West and India. You know, as a messenger, he was the right person because he had seen India as well as West from very close quarters. He knew Eastern and Western philosophy. When I say he knew West and India from very close quarters, it is from two different angles. When he is unknown monk and when he is a celebrity. From both the angles, he has seen Western as well as Indian society. He was also a person who, sitting at the feet of Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, had realized the highest truth of life. Because of that, it's not only the knowledge of the society or the philosophy, but he had the great compassion, the love, the feeling of oneness with the whole world. And it is out of that compassion the message came for the West as well as from India, for India. Again, he was a very great communicator. You know, though the message is same in the interest of the humanity, but when he speaks to the West, the language is different. When he speaks to India, the language is different. It doesn't mean that he was diplomatic, not at all. Actually, he never compromised with the truth. In one of his letters, he writes, "I have not come here to say goody-goody words, to good words. I have come to tell truth." And that's what he did. Whether he spoke in West, whether he spoke in India, he did not spare both the societies about their drawbacks or shortcomings. And that's why he could really give a message. What was for their good and what they had to get rid of. If we see the message, or we can say the whole basis or foundation of Swami Vivekananda's message, it is, you know, he says, the truth does not pay homage to society, whether ancient or modern. The society has to pay homage to truth or perish. Satya samaj ke ichha ke anusar badalta nahi hai. Samaj ko satya ke anusar jivan jina hai, nahi to woh samaj nashta hota hai. Achha, woh satya kya hai? Swami Vivekananda kehte hai, it's, you know, vision of oneness. Though we may all appear different, we are all interconnected, interrelated, interdependent. It is the same divine which has manifested as many. And therefore, as it was told by Swami Nikhileshwarananda ji, each soul is potentially divine. The goal of life is to manifest that divinity in life. So it means to connect with all the collectives that are there in this universe, to connect with the family, with the society, with the nation, with the humanity, and with the whole creation. That is what is the purpose of human life, and also to get rooted in one's own being. So the inner sadhana and the outer expression in our actions, by working for the harmony in family, society, nation, and the whole creation. That's what human life is for. But if a human being, because he is selfish, because he says, no, you know, I like to enjoy the world, or because he is fanatic, he says, I want to kill others, or because he, you know, does not believe in anything, just want to enjoy the life, will not really be in its interest, in his interest, because the life is not aligned with the truth of existence. Swami Vivekananda gives example. For example, gravitational force. Whether we accept or not, whether we believe in it or not. Because when we are part of this existence, the gravitational force will work on us. यदि कोई कहता है कि नहीं 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 ये तो न्यूटन ने डिस्कवर किया था, मैं इसके ऊपर विश्वास नहीं करता हूँ और इसीलिए मैं पांचवी मंजिल से कूदूंगा तो मैं नीचे नहीं ऊपर जाऊंगा, वो सच में ऊपर जाएगा लेकिन शरीर नीचे आएगा. जस्ट बिकॉज ही डज नॉट बिलीव इन इट, जस्ट बिकॉज ही इज इग्नोरेंट ऑफ इट, द ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स विल नॉट सीज टू वर्क ऑन हिम. The same way, the spiritual truth of existence is the oneness of existence. And if that we disregard and leave, we are sure to come to grief. That's what the basis. And that's how Swamiji says, this is what is actually the contribution of India to the world. Now, coming to just few points I have noted down about his message to West and message to India. You know the paper on Hinduism, which he presented in the Chicago Parliament of Religions. And he's one of the very, very inspiring lectures, Common Basis of Hinduism, which he delivered at Lahore. If we see both the lectures, you know the points are same, but the whole delivery is different. The whole communication is different. Anyone who wants to learn how to talk in the interest of others, how to communicate certain deeper principles to others without compromising with the truth but not hurting a person, he should read paper on Hinduism and also Common Basis of Hinduism. So when Swamiji, I am going to stick only to the paper on Hinduism, though Swamiji for 3.5 years he was traveling in the West and giving, you know, so many lectures through which he gave message to the world. But the seeds of that message is in the paper of Hinduism, though it was paper on Hinduism. But the message was to the world. I will just tell few because time is limited, so I have noted down so that I don't miss. You know, first thing he says that you don't love God, you know, for rewards. I love God because I should go to heaven. I should get such and such thing. This is not the real way of knowing God or realizing God. Love God for love's sake. Because He is divine. Because it is something lovable. And therefore you love. He gives very beautiful example from Mahabharata. He says, when Yudhishthir, all Pandavas and Draupadi were going, you know, something happened and then the Draupadi, she tells Yudhishthira कि क्या है आपने इतना सारा नियमों का जीवन भर पालन किया, धर्म का पालन किया और आपके जीवन में तो सारा दुख ही दुख है. तो वो कहते हैं द्रौपदी, मैं ये जो सत्य का पालन करता हूँ, मैं ये जो धर्म का पालन करता हूँ, मैं ये जो ईश्वर पे निष्ठा रखकर जीवन जीता हूँ, ये मुझे कुछ मिलना चाहिए इसलिए नहीं जी रहा हूँ, ये करना चाहिए इसलिए कर रहा हूँ. And then he gives example, you see the Himalayas, how beautiful. Itne bhavya hai ye Himalaya, ki wo dekkar hi hum usse prem karte hai, usse mujhe kuch milne wala hai, kuch nahi milne wala hai. So, jeevan mein jo udatta tattva hai, jo udatta dheya hai, uske liye hum kyun jina hai, mujhe kuch milna hai, isliye nahi, wo udatta hai, aur us udatta ke saath mujhe ek roop hona hai, isliye main uska palan karta hu. So the love for God is not for rewards. The love for God is not to go to heaven. That is too minor a thing. But it is to worship the divine. Another thing that he says, it's very interesting. He says, unity in variety is the plan of nature. You know, though we may all appear different, each one is unique. Though we may appear even, for example, you take any tree and just pluck 2-3 leaves. You know, the leaves appear similar, but they are not exactly the same. So we are all connected with each other, but we are not exactly the same. We are all different. And each one has something to contribute for the well-being of the humanity. So that is why we don't go and tell others, your God is wrong, your God is false, you are worshipping devil. No. His God is right for him. His worship, his prayer is right for him. My God is right for him. Because beyond all this, we are all connected. Jato mat tato pat. The divine is same. He can be worshipped, can be invoked by many names and gods. But if you start, you know, rejecting others, because there is nothing like others, it's all your own extended form. If you reject others, you are somewhere rejecting yourself. If you destroy others, you are destroying yourself. You see the history of all terrorist movement in the world. It starts to destroy others, but there is no others. We are all interconnected. So when they start destroying others, after a few years, they start killing each other. And that's what Swami Vivekananda warned us. Never reject anyone. Be inclusive. It is the exclusive approach saying, my God alone is true, has caused such bloodbath and such, Swamiji uses very strong words in the whole human society. Another thing, Swamiji, in paper on Hinduism, he explains everything, you know, in context of science. So he says, creation is without beginning and without end. You know, there is great compassion when Swamiji explaining is all this. Because there are two things. If you are religious fanatic, then you feel that, you know, and if you don't believe that creation is without beginning and without end, and world started on this and this day, and it's going to end on such and such day. So I have to work very hard. I have to, you know, go to heaven. So what God has told, I have to do accordingly. There is a sort of urgency. He works. Or if he does not, he is not religious fanatic, but he believes that, you know, this is the only life that we have got. This is the only creation, and it ends one day. It's linear. Then there is, you enjoy, one life is there. Enjoy as much as you want. Why you should bother about others? Why you should not exploit others? Exploit others and enjoy. Exploit the nature, exploit the society. So, but the fact is, creation is without beginning and without end. If this truth goes inside, you know, somewhere we will be accepting the whole universe as it is. The religious fanaticism can also go, and at the same time, that materialism will also reduce. Then he also says that, see, when we are interconnected with each other, our prayers can never be that only we should be happy. And therefore, he challenges, you know, he gives a challenge in while presenting paper on Hinduism. He says, let anyone in the world find out a prayer of Hindus where the Hindus say only Hindus will succeed or only Hindus will be happy and not others. So really, really speaking, because we are all, you know, expression of the one, our prayer is always sarve bhavantu sukhinaha, sarve santu niramaya. We don't say sarve bharatiyaha bhavantu sukhinaha. We say sarve bhavantu sukhinaha. That is, in that human beings and even non-human beings also are involved in it. There are so many points, but I will skip and I shall go now to the...
No, you take your own time.
Okay. So, you know, one more Swamiji says, that was mentioned also, he says that... you know, you don't come and teach religion to us in India. We have enough of religion. Actually, any type of religious tradition in the world, you can find in its gist or in its full expression in India. So he says, really, are you concerned? Then millions of my people are starving. Give them bread. And you are raising big, big churches. Swamiji is talking this, you know, in Parliament of Religion. Even he is referring to burning of witches, he is referring to inquisition, but without hurting the people. You know, that's a skill. We all of us have to learn that. If we really want to work in the interest of the society, how we should communicate, tell the truth, but also have that great compassion for the audience who are sitting in front of us, or whomsoever we are trying to tell. That's what Swami Vivekananda did in Chicago. And then he says, which was again quoted here, if the Parliament of Religion has shown us anything, it is this, that purity and holiness are not exclusive possessions of any church. You know, if anyone thinks that, and again, you know, Swamiji, I always feel Swamiji was at thought level also a very strategic person, not in a bad sense I am saying. You know, the whole parliament of religions was organized. One ulterior motive was to show that how Christianity alone is the right religion for the whole world. Of course, there were persons of very great heart, like, you know, Professor Wright and all. Such examples were very much there. But this was one of the motive. And therefore, Swamiji says, if parliament of religion has shown anything, it is this, that purity and holiness are not exclusive possessions of any church. All over the world, in all religious traditions, you will find such persons who are pure, who are holy, who have worked for others, who have given their life for others. And there are ennobling thoughts in each religious thought. So respect that and don't go and force yourself. And so that's how Swamiji's message continue. But now coming to the message of India, because that is also very important. You know, Swamiji, when he came back to India, when he went from here, he was an unknown monk. He had to collect 8 anna, 1 rupee. And like that he went. When he went there also, he had to struggle. But when Swamiji returned, you know, he is well-known in the whole world. Not only that, there are many persons following him. Like, you know, J.J. Goodwin was there, Mr. and Mrs. Saviors were there, following as brahmacharis. Behind Swamiji, they are coming. Then Sister Christine came, Margaret Noble came, who later became Sister Nivedita. And then the people of India who were trampled down for centuries together, who were slaves, who had lost all self-confidence, they thought, "Arre, Swamiji went with the thought of India, with the thought of Indian culture, and today he is revered all over the world. There are people from that country following him. Something we have missed. And now we have to listen to this man." And you know, as we know, Swamiji was everyone wanted. We have to read the letters from Maharashtra. People were calling him. Swamiji made 2 times plans also, but he was sick. He could not come. So Colombo to Almora, when he traveled, all those lectures, if we want to know the message for India, we have to read that. The first thing Swamiji said, he said it there, he said it here also, that each nation has a message to deliver, a destiny to fulfill, a mission to accomplish. So each nation has a purpose to progress the humanity towards that ultimate goal, you know, of harmony of existence. And so Swami Vivekananda says, our country also has a message to deliver. But for that, our nation will have to be reawakened. And that's what Chicago speech did. So Swamiji says that nation in India must be gathering up of its scattered spiritual forces whose hearts beat to the same spiritual tune. Very important words. Scattered spiritual forces. Why Swamiji is saying scattered spiritual forces? Because it is that message of spirituality that this country has to give to the world. And whose hearts beat to the same spiritual tune? Because spirituality we may define differently. But what India stands for, that oneness, that divinity of man, you know, the existence, the harmony in all the collectives. So that's how Swami Vivekananda, he aroused the national consciousness by giving the common basis of all religious traditions in India. That's what common basis of Hinduism paper is. Again, worth reading paper, worth studying. I will just tell those 6 points what Swamiji says. Some already have got covered, so I will just refer briefly. First thing he says, that you know, we believe in Vedas. Now Vedas is not a book, but it is, you know, a collection or a treasury of spiritual laws discovered by different men at different times. And again, here also he gives the same example of gravitational force. Whether it is known or not, the force works on us same way. These spiritual laws, when they are discovered and when we, you know, plan our life based on those spiritual laws, then only human being evolves. And that's why we believe in Vedas. The second, we say we are born, we live, and we die in Ishvara, that is God. In simple words, it is God is everywhere. You go anywhere in the country, ask any villager, where is God? The answer is same. You know, there is no circular. There is nothing, so to say, some central authority told this, and yet everywhere, this is the same vision that we share, that divine is everywhere. The third thing I just had mentioned, that creation is without beginning, without end. He says it's not someone sits and creates, it's the divine manifest itself. Then the third thing is, the man is not just body and the finer body, what we call as mind, but it is, you know, the soul which takes birth again and again before it knows itself. And fifth, amrutasya putraha. That is, we are all potentially divine. Shrunvanta vishve amrutasya putraha, as Swamiji told. The sixth is very important. Religion is not in believing, but it is in being and becoming. If I say, oh, I believe Krishna so much, but my behavior is not good, I am hurting others, I am humiliating others, I am not bothered about others, I am selfish, I only think of promoting myself, then I am not really following dharma. I may say, I may do morning 3 hours worship to Krishna, it has no meaning. Religion is in being and becoming. Then Swamiji says that, you know, there are two problems in front of the world when he talks in India. He says first is the religious fanaticism. If that is there, for that also India can guide. Sorry, three problems. The second is, you know, the way science is advancing slowly, all the old religious faiths are crumbling. It may appear contradictory, but that is how today the society is, we also know. And therefore, along with the tub, the baby is also thrown. So that should not happen. The faith in divine should continue. And Vedanta, in scientific way, can be explained to the people. More and more scientific discoveries are coming. They are only the faint echoes of the truths of Vedanta. That's how Swami Vivekananda puts it. And the third is, the materialism is taking over. Because earlier, somehow, people were held together, you know, with a fear of hell. Ab kitne samay dar dikha ke logon ko, aap achha se vyavahar kijiye, aisa mat kijiye, swarthi mat hoiye, aisa kitni baar bata sakte hai, niti matta se, nitiwan hoiye, niti niyamon ka palan kijiye, nahi karenge to, saitan aapko pakad lega, aap narak mein chale jayenge, narak mein hamesha jalte rahenge, aisa बहुत ज़्यादा देर तक नहीं हो सकता है. जैसे विज्ञान का प्रवास होने लग गया, वैसा ऐसे हुआ जो स्वामी जी ने एक्सपेक्ट किया था, और आज बहुत ज़्यादा हो गया है कि लोगों का सारा विश्वास ही उड़ गया. उन्होंने जा ठीक है, जब नरक आएगा देख लेंगे, अभी तो मजा कर लेंगे, और नरक आएगा देख लेंगे तो मैंने अभी क्यों नहीं मजा करना है, मैंने क्यों लोगों को शोषण करते हुए ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा पैसा कमाना है. यू नो मोनसांटो कंपनी, they are putting aspartame in all preservatives, even in vitamin tablets. So even children are getting affected, but they are not bothered, because we must earn as much as we can. Like that, this is a big story, how it is going on. So why not do it? I will go to the nark and see who will be always burning for this. This is not scientific. And doing this, people Niti se bhi bahar a gaye. So Swamiji says, it's only the vision of oneness which can explain why I should not hurt other. Because the other is not other. When I hurt other, actually I lose the peace. When I want put down others and progress, that is where I get tension in life. You know, I will just give you one example. Each one of us experience. If I do something wrong, I may answer back someone or whatever. You know, inside our mind, we go on justifying. वो ऐसा ही हमेशा बोलता था, उसको एक बार सुना नहीं चाहिए था। यानी थोड़ा सा हमने गलत कर दिया, हमें अंदर बहुत बार चक्की चलानी पड़ती है, मैंने जो किया वो सही था, क्योंकि वो दूसरा नहीं है, हम कनेक्टेड है। एंड दैट इज वाई स्वामी जी सेज व्हाई आई शुड नॉट हर्ट अदर्स, बिकॉज अदर्स आर कनेक्टेड विथ मी। दिस इट सेल्फ इज अ वेरी वेरी बिग एंड वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक, बट वी शैल मूव फर्दर। एंड बट स्वामी जी सेज इफ दिस मैसेज वी हैव टू गिव टू द वर्ल्ड, फर्स्ट वी विल हैव टू रेज अवर सेल्स, एंड फॉर दैट हिज कॉल इज to the youth. He says, you know, oneness is not only the principle that we have to give to the world, that's already digitalized, it is already available in books, but it is, you know, all that is abstract, the values are abstract, the vision of oneness is abstract, that can be understood only if it is manifested in our life. For example, the social scientists say, yadi mata pita ka divorce hua hai, तो बच्चों का डाइवोर्स होने की संभावना 50% बढ़ जाती है, क्योंकि बच्चों को पता ही नहीं है कि माता पिता एक दूसरों के लिए कैसा त्याग करते हैं, एक दूसरों को स्वीकार करते हैं, काम करते हैं, ये बच्चों को पता नहीं है। यदि दादा दादी और नाना नानी और माँ पिता का भी डाइवोर्स हो गया है तो बच्चों का डाइवोर्स होने की संभावना 80% से भी बढ़ जाती है। यानी किसी एक कंट्री ने ऐसा किया था कि इफ़ यू डोंट टेक डिवोर्स फॉर 5 years, यू नो, यू विल गेट सम टैक्स एग्जेम्पशन। अभी टैक्स एग्जेम्पशन मिलेगा इसलिए डिवोर्स नहीं लेंगे, ऐसा नहीं होता है। ये जीना कैसे है, एक दूसरों को स्वीकारना कैसा है, ये तत्व प्रत्यक्ष उदाहरण से ही समझते हैं। इसीलिए जब हम वननेस की बात कर रहे हैं, हमें क्या करना है, हमें ऐसे परिवार की संस्था निर्माण करनी है जो आत्मीयता पर आधारित है। वननेस मीन्स व्हाट, अपनी आत्मीयता, अपनापन। ऐसी समाज संस्थाएं खड़ी करनी है, शिक्षा संस्थाएं खड़ी करनी है, व्यापार संस्थाएं खड़ी करनी है जो आत्मीयता पर आधारित है, जो कॉम्पिटिशन पर नहीं, जो हायर एंड फायर पर नहीं, जो दूसरों को दबाकर आगे जाने वाली नहीं। ऐसे हमें पूरा नेशनल रीबिल्डिंग करना है। इसीलिए स्वामी जी कहते थे, मैंने 1500 बरस का काम देकर मैं जा रहा हूँ। सारी व्यवस्थाएं हमें खड़ी करनी है, तब ये आत्मीयता क्या है ये समझेगा। और जिस प्रकार से हम पूरे विश्व को संदेश देना चाहते हैं, वो संदेश इन उदाहरणों में से होगा। तो पहले तो ये हमारे जीवन में आनी है, ये पहले सारी संस्थाएँ खड़ी करने के पहले। एंड दैट्स वाई स्वामी जी यूज टू से, डू यू फील फ्रॉम द हार्ट। हम बस अपना ही करियर में आज लगे हुए हैं। ही यूज टू से, दे अलोन लिव हु लिव फॉर अदर्स, द रेस्ट आर मोर डेड देन अलाइव। कल्पना कीजिए, स्वामी विवेकानंद जब शिकागो में थे, प्रसिद्ध नहीं हुए थे, वो खत में लिखते हैं, आई मे डाई ऑफ कोल्ड एंड हंगर। उसी खत में वो आगे लिखते हैं, 100,000 मेन एंड वीमेन फायर्ड विद द झील ऑफ होलीनेस, फोर्टिफाइड विद द इटर्नल फेथ इन लॉर्ड, नर्व टू द लायंस करेज। ये लायंस करेज, मृगेंद्र का धैर्य क्यों आया है, बिकॉज नर्व टू द लायंस करेज बाय देयर सिंपथी फॉर द पुअर एंड द फॉलन एंड द डाउन ट्रडन शैल गो टू द लेंथ एंड ब्रेथ ऑफ दिस लैंड प्रीचिंग द गॉस्पेल ऑफ इक्वेलिटी, गॉस्पेल ऑफ सोशल रेजिंग अप, गॉस्पेल ऑफ हेल्प। Really, who will go? Are we in his 100,000? Can I really say, yes, my some time will be spent to serve those who are in interior parts, those who are, they are deprived, who are poor, who are suffering. Can I give my at least some time? I am studying all that, but can I give my some time and work for the society? This call of service of Swami Vivekananda, if we really have that oneness in our heart with our society, we will inculcate. And it's only then, when our young India rises, it's only then we can say that India will rise and guide the world. That's how Swami Vivekananda says in one of his speech. You know, with what love he says, you young men, will you respond to the call of your nation? Or are you going to only live for yourself? You know, you are born in such great land, which can give this message of spirituality, message of oneness to the whole world. So will you respond to the call of your nation? Up India, conquer the world. Just making India economically all right, he says, that's a too small a dream. up India, conquer the world with your whole spirituality. So here Swamiji gives a very fiery message. He says you are being trampled down like worms and you are, you know, wriggling just like in that gobar mein kide hote hai na. Aisa jeevan hum ji rahe, koi bhi aata hai, humare baare mein kuch bhi bolta hai, humare upar paav rakhta hai, hum sara sahen kar rahe. Pahle manushya bano, uthkar khade ho jao, utho jago, aur dheya prapt hone tak ruko mat. Phir Swami Vivekananda kehte hai, wo ek akhir ka ye batate huye main samapt karungi. Kalpana kijiye un dinon mein jab desh daridra mein, agyan mein, gulami mein gira hua hai. Swami Vivekananda kehte hai, I do not look into the future, nor do I care to look. But one vision is coming very clear in front of my eyes. Un dinon mein aisa bolna kitna kathin hoga, lekin sach mein Swami ji ne drushya dekha hai. One comes very clear in front of my eyes, this ancient mother of ours is rising again, rejuvenated, sitting on a throne more glorious than ever. And then mark very carefully the words, proclaim her with the words of peace and benediction in the world. You know, whenever India rises, it is for the good of the humanity. So proclaim her with the words of peace and benediction. And to do that, all of us, we have to become rishis. Rishis means those who sacrifice. Rishis means those who don't get caught up in the senses, but they say there is something beyond that. And rishis means those who don't get boggled down by the situation around, problems around, but they rise and they see the glorious future that is coming up. And all of you, you know, the young sisters and brothers sitting here, you know, you are born in very opportune time. If really you become such rishis, if really you think of country, think of the whole humanity and work, this country will come up in no time, because already it is in that stage. And then, as Swamiji had envisaged, you know, we will proclaim her with the words of peace and benediction to the whole world. What Swamiji wanted to happen for the West, what Swamiji wanted, the West should not suffer because of the shortcomings in her thought, and that we have to remove. But we have to also learn from the West, you know, the lack of jealousy, the sense of organizing. They organize and achieve the things. All that also Swamiji said. So it is that message, as Swami Nikhileshwarananda ji said, though this may be concluding program, it is not concluding. We have to get up and start working for our country. With those words, I conclude. Thank you.
Thank you, Nivedita ji, for those wonderful, inspiring words with oneness and overcoming the fanatism and bringing the service to the humanity, to our life.